獅山學會的是Miss Samantha.
Thank you. The Lionrock Institute believes that to say that women need to be encouraged back into the workforce, quite frankly, is insulting.
Thank you, lady.
To say that women's participation in the workforce needs to be bolstered to increase society's productivity is a lie. GNP, or the female labour force participation rate, are simply statistics. They only have the value which we want to attach to them. Something which is not caught by these statistics, not accounted for in GNP, is the value added by a homemaker providing a loving and supportive environment as her child grows, should this be her choice. And that is just it. This is a choice. Who are you to say that she has made the wrong choice choosing to be a homemaker rather than a member of the counted labour force? We reject the entire premise of the government's inquiry, which is that Hong Kong women were somehow forced to become homemakers, and the insulting belief that they need an artificial push to get back into the workforce. Firstly, this implies that homemakers contribute nothing to society. If the government recognised the incalculable value of a homemaker, then maybe they would better understand that simply pushing women into work is not going to produce a better outcome. The second thing I see wrong with this is that it panders to the belief that women are delicate and require assistance to make choices. With one premise, 100 years of global women liberation has effectively been overturned here in Hong Kong. Women, just like men, act in self-interest. They weigh up decisions and act in a way which they believe will maximise theirs and their family's well-being. Who is the government to intervene in this process? A question posed by the government was, how do we better encourage homemakers back into the workforce? My answer to this would be, do not price them out of the market with minimum wage. Minimum wage is an artificial determination which has no ascertainable link to what was actually contributed. Maybe if the government were to remove minimum wage, then the homemakers they've identified as wanting employment may be able to find it. It is a fact that when a homemaker re-enters the labour market after a long period out, it is likely that readjustments are required, and during this time, a low wage is needed to enable such readjustments. When employers do not have the relevant flexibility to offer this and employees the flexibility to accept, it simply creates less employment, not more. The Lionrock Institute believes that the government is merely doing this consultation for show. It is merely a discussion to satisfy trade unionists who have passed the minimum wage law and are now seeing the consequence. The Lionrock Institute looks forward to the actual discussion regarding population policy, the discussion on birth rate and immigration, and of course, the true reason we are here, which is an unsustainable welfare structure on the population trajectory. Thank you.
Thank you.